I welcome you all in the next video tutorial of Remedial Biology BP106RBT theory part. So far we have covered the five kingdom of classification as well as the binomial nomenclature. So in this video tutorial we are going to see and cover the definition and the diversity of the living world. So without wasting any time further, let's start the diversity in the living world. So yes, as you know, as you have basically from the known medical background, so don't worry, I will clear all your concept in the later videos also. So biology is a branch of science which deals with the living beings and their functions. Bio itself means the living. Bio means living. So biology is the branch of science which deals with the living beings and their function. And we know there is a great diversity in the living beings on this planet. And we know there is a great diversity. Human beings are living. We say that plants have also living things. Animals, we have different type of species of different animals. So yes, there is a diversity all over. If we seen around, agar hum apne aas paas bhi dekhe, toh we see birds, we see reptiles, we see any other aquatic organisms. So yes, there is a diversity. And this all things have given by us the nature. The nature has given us these flora as well as the fauna. So flora, flora, which means related to the plant, and fauna, fauna, it relates to the animals. Okay, so nature has given us these flora and fauna as well as the natural resources. Okay, so we are humans are basically we are nothing but we are just exploiting these resources to survive for our survivability. Hum kya kar rahe hain? We are exploring. We are exploring animals. We are exploring plants. We are exploring the nature. We are exploring the total wealth of the nature for our sustainability, for our development, for our. So this is not our aim. So our aim is also to return back, to give back to the nature. Yes, development is necessary, but we cannot compromise environment. So nowadays, now scientists are also working on this, and the concept of sustainable development has been occurred. Okay, so we will talk this some another time. So let's focus on our topic because we will divert from that now. So the what is living? It is very difficult to define living, and conventionally various common characteristics to all living beings to be identified. Some of them are listed below, like all the living organisms have cellular organization. Yes, we have different type of cells, different type of organs. We have different metabolism. We have a growth system. Yes, we can reproduce by different methods, and we can also respond to a particular stimulus. So how can we say that there is a diversity? As you can see this, it is estimated that more than 5 million species are present on the earth. And of these, about 1.7 million species are known and been described. Yet there are millions of species, they have not been identified and yet to be described. So you can imagine how diversity is all over. So every year new species have been described and added to the list. This is important. So even this 2020 period, the number of species has been new, of the animals also, of the plants also, or maybe some any other kingdom. They have been identified and described by various scientists, or you can say taxonomists, botanists, or the zoologists who are working in a particular field. So yes, every year several new species has been described and added to the list. So if we talk about the nomenclature, actually we have covered this point in the previous tutorials. So just give a look on this. If we talk about the nomenclature, we follow binomial nomenclature. Okay, and it was given by Carlos Linnaeus. Okay, and just say for example, human beings, Homo sapiens. So we have a name of Homo sapiens. Magnifera indica, mango. We have already covered this point. Okay, and we have seen this. This is important that you have to remember. So there is some taxonomical categories. Taxus means class basically. How will you categorize a particular organism? So we have developed. Humans have developed species. we name to the plant, we give the scientific names to the plant, so as to understand them better. We developed genus. So genus, what is genus? Genus is a group of related species which have some correlated characteristics. So we have developed families. The family is nothing but it is a group of related genera. The different genera comprises of family. And then order, the order includes all the related families. Whereas the class, several related orders are included in the particular class. Then we talk about the phylum. The phylum in the animals and divisions in plants included in related classes. Okay, and last, kingdom. The kingdom comprises of various phyla of the animals and various divisions of the plant. So this is a taxonomical hierarchy in the ascending order. So you have to remember this. So this is the lowest one and this is the highest one. Okay, if we talk about species, lowest one, what is species? Species is the basic unit of classification. The member of the species are closely related and they derive from common ancestor and can be interbreed to produce fertile offspring. So you have to remember lowest unit is a species. Then we go for the genus, family, order, class, phylum, or kingdom. Maybe you can also, taxonomist has also classified, again, suppose this is species, genus, family, then again is a subfamily. Okay, order, maybe it is a suborder, class, maybe it's a subclass, is also there. So it will depend upon the particular type of organism that we are going to characterize or that we are going to classify. So what is taxonomy? It's a method of the classification basically. Okay, I hope this is clear. So you have to remember this order because this is very, very important. Taxonomical categories showing the taxonomical hierarchy in the ascending order. Here we can increasing the order. So this is the lowest one, this is the highest one. And we know there are five kingdom of the classifications also. Okay, so if we talk about example, so take an example of human, Homo sapiens. So how we can classify ourselves, how can we classify humans? So we have a kingdom. Okay, so let's start with the species. Okay, species is, our species is sapiens, our genus is Homo, our family is Hominidae, our order is primates. We belong to the class of mammalia because we are basically, mammalia is related to the milk secretion. Okay, then phylum is Chordata. We have a Chordata phylum and we have a kingdom of Animalia. And remember this thing, each of these have a particular characteristics. Okay, and so let's see upon Chordata. Why we belong to Chordata? See here, phylum Chordata belongs to the kingdom Animalia and includes all the vertebrates, that is the animal with a backbone, and several invertebrates, that is the organism without a backbone. Okay, so this is about the phylum Chordata. So I want to say that there are different type of characteristic of each of the particular taxonomical unit. We can call them, also call them as a taxonomical unit. Okay, so if you talk about the, so this is time, we have less time. So if you talk about the coconut, so yes, we have a coconut, that is a nareal. It has a scientific name, botanical name, Coccus nucifera. So yes, species is Nucifera, genus Coccus, family Ericaceae, principal is, order is the principals, class is the monocot. So it is belong to the monocot. I hope you remember about this. Division Angiospermae, again, it is a flowering plant. Angiosperm are the flowering plants, whereas the gymnosperms do not bear any flower. Then it belongs to the kingdom Plantae. Okay, so it, as it is a plant, so it belongs to the kingdom Plantae. So you have to remember at least one example. So I hope this is clear to you. So this is the diversity that we are having in the living world. So in the last, I acknowledge all the sources I have used to prepare this video. So do not share this video in any platform. This video is only intended for the education purpose for you students. Again, thank you very much for your patience and listening. See you in the next video tutorial.